Hi, I'm Michael Rutherford, and I'm an exercise physiologist and have over 20 years of experience training multiple athletes in various sports. I've worked with youth athletes, high school, collegiate, Olympic, and international competitors. Today we're going to talk about how to get stronger and how to get bigger. How to gain 5 pounds of mass this week. Now, I've spent 20 years working with youth, high school, collegiate, Olympic, and international competitors, and a lot of those individuals are looking for ways to gain mass, to gain strength. And we're going to talk to you about that today and tell you exactly how to get it done. First requirement is progressive resistance training. And what do I mean by progressive resistance training? That means we're going to use the old school barbell set to train with. The next part of this process is the proper dietary support. That includes water. There's a lot of junk out there that you pour down into your stomach, but water is going to be very important. And finally, we're going to talk to you about adequate rest. The bigger progressive resistance training routine is going to focus on those free weights. Free weights hold several advantages. First of all, they're readily available. You can get them almost anywhere, and they're very inexpensive. Around 3 cents a pound, including the bar and the collars, which is dirt cheap. They're relatively safe when used with your head, using them with your head and concentrating on what you're doing, and they'll allow the athlete to work in space, forcing stabilization and multiple recruitment patterns on these complex movements. Okay, the elements of the bigger program, we talked about that. Resistance training, 3 days per week. That's all we're going to ask you to do. Monday, Wednesdays, and Fridays. Then, we don't want those sessions to exceed 60 minutes. If we go over 60 minutes with our training, then we're going to activate the stress response, and actually we're going to impede muscular development, mass, and adding mass to the body. We're going to follow a single progression program. That's 3 sets of 10 repetitions each. And we want to use a moderate rest interval. Well, what do I mean by moderate? We don't want you talking and walking around and socializing in the gym. We want to keep it to about 90 seconds between sets and exercises. So we got a pretty stiff pace that we're going to maintain. We're going to focus on the following core exercises. The back squat. This is a cornerstone exercise to any mass building program. If you can't learn or teach yourself to back squat, you're going to have trouble gaining that mass. We're going to also use the deadlift. The deadlift is an alternative movement to the back squat. It'll give us a slightly different stimulus and actually help us accelerate our gain. We're going to focus on the bench press, the upper body squat. Everybody wants to know how much you're going to bench press. We're going to have that in our program to gain mass. We're going to also utilize the upper body barbell row, which is a basic exercise that focuses on the back musculature to give you that V shape that everybody's looking for. And finally, we're going to conclude with the standing press. The standing press is a classic exercise, builds extreme power in the shoulder girdle, and by standing on our feet, we're going to force the core musculature to be activated. All right, let's talk about the nutrition program. We want to eat real food. What am I talking about here? Meat. That's red meat, fish, and chicken, and eggs. We want to include those with every meal. We also want to include dairy. That's cheese, milk, yogurt, and those products from that family. Finally, we want to make sure that we have adequate amount of vegetables and fruit. That's anything that's green. I talk about Roy green. That's red, orange, yellow, and green in the vegetable family. And finally, fruits. Bananas, oranges, apples, grapes, you name it. If it's in the fruit and salad bar, you should eat it. And finally, plenty of water. Plenty of water. Okay, I talked about protein with every meal. Very important. You want to have at least a serving with every meal, and a serving is whatever you can fit in your hand. We want to eat 5 or 6 meals per day. This should include 3 regular meals, that's breakfast, lunch, and dinner, and 2 major snacks. 2 major snacks. A major snack could be fruit with yogurt, okay? It could be an additional sandwich that you make with meat and cheese. It could be a large serving of milk, a big glass of milk, with a peanut butter sandwich. We want to make sure that we have major snacks. If you want to gain mass, you got to put the fuel in the tank. Well, let's talk about milk. Classic strongmen from our past have built tremendous size by consuming an abundance of milk. And it sounds crazy, but I want you to work towards consuming 1 gallon of milk each and every day. Don't start out drinking 1 gallon of milk, but work towards drinking 1 gallon of milk over the first 4 weeks. To begin with, you need to drink milk with every meal. Let's talk about another beverage that's really important today. Water. Now, if you're someone who drinks soda pop, you've got to cut that out of your life. Drinking water is one of the most valuable things that you can do for your health and to gain mass. We want to drink in the neighborhood of 1/2 ounce to 1 ounce of water per pound of body weight each and every day. And you're going to need to use a strategy to accomplish this. You need to drink water first thing in the morning when you get up. You're going to need to drink it between meals. And you're going to make sure you drink plenty of it during exercise. Very important. You're going to need to keep record of how much you weigh and how much you're eating. And you can do this by journaling. You don't need a fancy journal. You can get a $2 notebook, spiral notebook, and keep all this information in front of you. Don't kid yourself. I've seen more athletes fail at gaining mass because they think they're eating, they think they're training, but there's no support, there's no document to prove that. We want to make sure that we avoid man-made or processed foods. Fried foods need to be eliminated, and I've already mentioned how nasty soft drinks and soda pop are. They're full of sugar, and they'll make you fat and slow. Every year, Americans consume 365 sodas per year. That's 12 teaspoons of sugar in each soda drink. Finally, sleep. This is the stage where your muscles grow. First, you stimulate the muscles through training, which we're going to talk about here shortly. Then you put in the proper nutrition with the real food diet. And finally, you need to sleep. You need to sleep a minimum of 8 hours each evening. Any variation in your sleep pattern will short circuit your recovery and will limit your gains. You need to learn to go to bed at the same time and get up each morning at the same time. Is this going to cut into your social life? Likely, but you need to pay the price if you want to make the gains. You want to make sure you limit your caffeine and your alcohol before you go to bed. These will disrupt your sleep physiology and interrupt that recovery process. Make sure you eliminate interruptions at night, such as telephones, cell phones, pagers, stereos, televisions, roommates, you name it, anything that you know of that can interrupt your recovery, interrupt your sleep. Make your sleep environment dark and cool. Get some additional window covering if necessary. Make the investment. Make the investment. Wash your bedding every week. Nobody wants to bed down in a smelly bed. Make your bed a comfortable place to go to at the end of the day. Okay, what we want to do now is we want to focus on the core exercises that we're going to do to become stronger and to gain mass, to become bigger. But first, we want to warm up the body a little bit before we start tossing this iron around. So I want to give you a few options here. First option, and something you can alternate these or rotate these around, is just to get a simple jump rope. Jump rope is a great warm-up exercise. It can be the exercise activity itself. Working initially just to get a minute of continuous jumping will be a significant challenge for most people. So I know that you can get those at TidalBoxing.com, and they have a variety of ropes to work with. I like the leather ropes, and it's a really, really nice thing to have with you at all times. And then you can also utilize some of these body weight exercises that I'm going to demonstrate right now for you. One of my favorite stretches, and I learned from my friends at CrossFit, they call it the Samson stretch, where we're going to interlace the fingers and extend the arms above the head, taking a lunge step out with the thigh parallel to the floor, and then we're just going to hold it in this position. They work towards 30 seconds of continuous holds. You can work the back leg, the trail leg, move it backwards. You'll feel the stretch in the front of the hip and the hip flexors. And then we just hold that for a period of time. Come back to the start and alternate legs and switch legs. You can do this in a dynamic fashion as well. If you purchase some of the other tapes, you'll notice that we use this as part of our dynamic warm-up in the speed video, the Go Faster video. Okay, that's the first option right there. I really like that stretch to start out with. We'll then move to another stretch. These are called overhead squats or snatch grip squats. We take these from Olympic lifting, and it's a great exercise to warm up the lower extremity, again providing stretch in the upper body. I'm just using a simple broom handle right here. You can get an expensive dowel, but just get into your broom closet and take one of those handles out. And we're just going to keep the arms extended. The arms are in a bone-to-bone contact. You can see that, by the way, I'm holding this stick. If it was a weight, that I would be able to support this. If the bar gets too far forward, I'll lose it if it was loaded. Or if it's too far back, I would lose it. So we want to keep it straight over the head. And then I'm just going to sit down in the hole, keeping my heels on the ground.